Hello students, welcome to Olympiad Scholar. So I am your Olympiad tutor. Hope you are all doing well. So today we will be discussing about the National Interactive Math Olympiad, which is commonly known as NIMO, and which is being organized by Eduheal Foundation. Okay. So I have this, I have taken this question paper for class 1 students, and this is a level 1 question paper, and the set is like A1. Okay. So you can log in to their website, which is www.eduhealfoundation.org, to get all other information. So students, I would like to tell you, enroll yourself in this Olympiad, so they will definitely enhance your mental ability and your intelligence level. Jump onto the first question, okay, which is from the mental ability. So the question is asking, look at the picture given below. Which of the following sequence represents the given picture? So you can like observe there are two balls in each place. So here it is written that 2 plus 4 plus 2 2 plus 4. No, we can't find this sequence as mentioned in the option 1, so it cannot be our answer. So let us check the second option, which is saying 2 plus 2 plus 4. Again it is not, because we have 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. Again this cannot be our option. So let us check the third option. This is saying that this is 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, which is exactly same as the figure. Okay, so let us jump on to the next question. Okay, so here a picture is given, and this person's name is Anil, this is Ria, and next to Ria is Siddharth, and on the extreme right Anita is there. Okay, so let us like read the question. Okay, so which of the above is the correct order from the shortest to tallest? Shortest means, okay, this is short and this is tall. So if you closely look at the figure, you can identify that Ria is the shortest, okay, among all these persons. Then come, so if you say this is 1, so Siddharth will become 2, and according to the height, Anita will be 3rd, and this Anil is the tallest person. So first Ria, okay, it is correct, but nowhere you see Ria. Okay, so this is the correct option, and we can also check whether as per our numbering the options are given or not. So this is Ria, okay, it is correct. Then comes Siddharth, okay, it is also correct. Then Anita, okay, again correct, and Anil, okay, it is exactly same as we have numbered. Okay, so let us read the question number 3. Okay, so the question number 3 says, Deepika has this note. So you can see this is a 10 rupee note. Which of the following she can buy? So this doll cost 50 rupees. So it is too costly, and it is rupees 8. So like Deepika has 10 rupees, so she can buy this ice cream cone. Okay, so let us check other options. So this color packet is worth 25 rupees. So right now she won't be able to buy this one. So our option is like option 2, that is ice cream, which can be bought with 10 rupees. Okay, so now we have got the question number 4, which is saying our beautiful figure is given, that is Christy and Dev are standing on a ruler, a numbered ruler. So what I can see over here, so let us read the question first. So Dev and Christy are playing a game. Okay, very good. So Dev asked Christy to move 2 steps towards him. Okay, now Dev is asking Christy to move towards mane. So if Christy has to move, then she has to move in this direction, not away from Dev. If she would have to move away, so then she will be like moving in the opposite direction. But Dev and Christy are playing a game. Dev asks Christy to move 2 steps towards him. If Christy is at 3rd steps, okay, like it is shown in the figure, Oh, now currently he is at stage 3, then where will she be after the movement or moving? So if she moves towards that, she, as I have already told you, she will be moving in this direction and she will move like 2 steps. So if in the first step she will come to 4th position, in the next step she will come to 5th position. Okay, so definitely the answer is option 2, that is 5. So let's jump on to the next question. Okay, now we are at the question number 5. So a beetle has 6 legs. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, very good. So how many legs do 2 beetles have? So as you see, 6, this beetle has 6 legs, also this beetle has also 6 legs. So you have to add these 2 numbers to get the answer. So you must be knowing 6 plus 6 is 12, or if you find it difficult, then you can count all the legs of this beetle and this beetle as well to find the answer, which is 12. So now we will discuss about the question number 6, which is asking about what is the time. I hope you are now able to tell the time by watching this type of clocks. Okay, this is an analog clock, this is not digital. In digital clocks, times are directly written as like this. Okay, 8:15. We don't have to we can directly read the time from the digital clock. So as this is an analog clock, we have to read the time from this. So you can observe this hour hand is pointing towards 9 and this minute hand is pointing towards 12. So the time is 9 o'clock. So the answer is option 1, that is 9. So let us go to the next question, which is question number 7, and it is asking us to complete the missing pattern. So in this pattern, you have to observe this type of pattern carefully so that you can find out the missing figure. So if you will observe carefully the first 3 figures, so it is a star, then comes a triangle, then comes a circular object. So again, it is being repeated in the second stage, like a star is there and there is a question mark and a circular object, then also a star is coming. So we have to find the figure which is after star and before the circular object, which is a triangle. Okay, so you can find the triangle from the option, and here the triangle is present in the option number 2, which is our answer. So let us jump on to the question number 8. So there is a beautiful train. Okay, so which comes next? So there are some numbers written on the boxes, that is 35, 36, 37, 38. So if you will count in this way, the number which is next to 38 can be our answer, that is 39. Okay, very good. So 39 is at option 3 and this is our answer. So let's look at the question number 9. Here is it, your question number 9. So there are so many figures drawn here. So we have to find how many triangles are there. So this is not a triangle, this looks like a square. So these are a circular. Okay, we can we can tell that these are circles, and these are also squares. And below them there are some stars, so none of them are triangles. So in here you see there are some triangles. So this is number 1, this is number 2, this is number 3, and this is number 4. So we have this option 2 is correct, which is saying that there are 4 triangles. So let's read the question number 10. You have 5 beers and you give away 2. So initially you have 5 beers and you just give away 2. Give away 2 means you have to cancel the two bits from this five. So you will be left with only three bits. So this option is correct. Okay, let us go to the next question, which is question number 11, and it is from mathematics section. So if 9 plus 9 is 18, then what is 18 minus 9? See, if you will closely observe this like statement or sentence or expression, whatever you can call it. So 2 9s make 18. So that means if this 18 is made by adding 2 9s. So if you take out 1 9 from this, then you will get another 9. Or you can say 18 minus 9 is again 9, as 9 plus 9 is 18. So your answer will be like option 3, and it is 9. So the next question, let us read it first. Ritu has 6 pencils, she buys 4 pencils more. How many pencils does she have now? Does she? Okay, it has to be she has now. Okay, does she? Does she have now? It is grammatical correct. Okay, I'm sorry. So Ritu has like 6 pencils, she buys 4 more pencils. That means previously she has 6 pencils, and now she buys how many pencils more? She buys like 4 more pencils. So 6 plus 4. So you have to count forward from 6, another 4. So after 6, you have like 7, okay, 8, 9, and 10. So answer would be like 10. So this is the option. Okay. Option 3, and it is 10. Okay. So let us like delete all this. Okay. So so let us check number 13, which is saying Anjali is thinking of a number if it has 7 groups of 10 and 6 more. So whatever Anjali is thinking, she has 7 groups of 10. So 7 groups of 10 means 7 tens. So 7 tens, 7. Okay, let me write 7 tens, you know it is 70. Okay, so I am just struggling to write over this PDF, so excuse me for that. So this is 70 and 6 more, that means you have to add like 6 more to it. So definitely it is 7 tens and 6 ones, so you have to find 76. Okay. So let's jump on to the next question, which is question number 14. It is saying Richa had 16 chocolates, she gave half of them to Ruchi. How many did Ruchi get? So as 16 chocolates, okay, Richa had 16 chocolates, so she gave half of them. So if you will make half, then it will like become 8 plus 8. Okay. So now how many did Ruchi get? So Ruchi got 8. Okay, 8 chocolates. Option number 2 is correct. So let us check the question number 15, which is asking us to find the missing number. See, so just check the series. It is 56, it is 57, then there is a missing number, then 59, then there is a missing number, and then 6. So if you will count right from 56, okay, so you can have the numbers. Okay, so this is 56, 57, it has to be 58, then 59, then 60, then 61. So our numbers are like 58 and 60. Okay. Again, I am telling it is very difficult to write. Okay. Just okay, 60. So like the answer would be like option number 3, which is 58 and 60. Let us erase first. Okay. That's good. So next comes question number 16. Count the triangles. It's a very easy question, as we only have to count these triangles. There are exactly 1, 2, 3, 4 triangles, and option number 1 is correct. So the next question is asking to find the circle. So this is not a circle, this is a box instead. So we can tell it a cuboid, and this is a cone, and this is the circle, option number 2. Okay, so let's go to the question number 8. So order the group of numbers from least to greatest. That means you will have the least number first, that is the lowest number or the smallest number, and you can move towards the greatest number. So you closely look at all the series, then you can see and observe that this is the correct answer. So 7, again it is increased to 42, then to 47, then to 51. It is in the correct order, but in all other cases, see, if you check, this is 47 and it has been decreased to 42, so it cannot be the answer. Again it is 47 and 42, so again it is decreased. So from least to greatest means it, you can say that it has to be in the increasing order or ascending order. So choose the clock showing 12:30. So this is the first figure. It is okay, the hour hand is between 12 and 1, and the minute hand is exactly at 6. So this is the correct option, this is 12:30. If you check out this figure, then it is 11:30. Okay, this is 11:30. Okay, how can I write? Okay, it is done, 11:30. So is there any other figure? Yes, the third figure is there, and it is like 1 and 2, it is in between, the hour hand is in between these two, so it has to be 1:30. It is 1:30. Okay, we got it correct. So let us read the next question. What comes after? So again, it is you have to observe this pattern, and you can say the next figure. So there is a star, there is a circle, and there is a square inside which a circle is there. Then it is being repeated in the next two figures, that is the star is there and a circle is there, but this is missing. So this has to be our answer, that is the option 3. Okay. So question number 21 is asking for 2 rupees by using the 1 rupee coins. Okay, it is 2 rupees, but again a 2 rupee coin has been shown, so this cannot be our answer. We need to make 2 rupees by using 1 rupee coins. So these are all 1 rupee coins, but this will make 3 rupees. So our answer is like option number 3, which is 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 rupees. Okay, so let us go to the question number 22. Choose the flat object. See, this like bell is not flat, it is a circular object, and its surface is not flat. So this is not a flat object. Mango is also like irregular surface. It is also, you can say that circular object. So this is a comb, and this is a flat surface. Okay, so question number 22, option 2 is correct. So let us jump on to the next question, which is question number 23. So find the smaller one. So the figures, from the figures you cannot say that which is the smaller one. In fact, you have to like find out what creature it is. It is an ant, so this is like a rabbit, and this is a bird. So the ant is the like a smaller one, so it is a very small creature in comparison to this parrot and this rabbit. Okay, so let us go to the next question, that is question number 24. Pick out the heavy object. Okay, so there are some books in the option 1, and number 2 is a rocket type figure is there, and third one is the butterfly. So definitely this will be the heaviest object among these 3. So next, question number 25. What is on the left? So right now, if you are watching this, so towards the right, so the elephant is there. So your option would be like number 2, elephant. How do you make 4? The question number 26 is asking to make 4. So if you will subtract 1 from 3, we will get 2. And if you will add 0 to 4, you will definitely get 4. If you will subtract 3 from 9, you will get 6. So our answer is option number 2. So let's move on to the question number 27. Okay, what sign is missing? So we have to put a sign. So let us check the plus sign. If we put the plus sign, then 7 will be added to 4 and that cannot make 3. Again, we will check minus. If we will put a minus sign, so 7 minus 4, yes, it is 3. That means 4 is taken away from 7. If you like erase 4 lines after drawing 7 lines, so definitely you will get 3 lines. So number 2 option is correct. So next question is asking us that how many Thursdays are there in June. So this is a calendar of June 2017. So this is Thursday. Okay, this is Thursday, and in here you can count the number of dates. Okay, so Thursday, that is June 1, June 8, June 15 and June 22 and June 29. So all of these dates are Thursday. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So we will have 5 Thursdays, which is option number 3. Okay, let us jump on to the question number 29. So choose the shape that is not a closed figure. See, it is a closed figure. It is not open from anywhere. It is also a closed figure. Okay. But this, if you will check this boundary, so like this figure is like, okay, this, and it is open from this side. So you can say this is not a closed figure. So for this, we are having this option 2 is correct. So let us read the question number 30. Ritu buys 3 pads of paper. 3 pads, that is pad number 1, pad number 2, pad number 3. Each pad has 10 sheets. So like this pad has 10 and this pad has 10 sheets and this pad has 10 sheets of paper. So 10 plus 10 becomes 20, then you are 10 to get 30. So 3 tens, that is 30, will be our answer, that is in the option 3. So now we will move to the interactive section. Okay, so in this section we are having 10 questions. Okay, so please concentrate on these questions. So match the figure with the similar shape. So this is an object and these are like some shapes. So this is object is like similar to this figure or this figure or this figure. Is it similar to a rectangle? Is it similar to a ball like shape or it is similar to a apple like shape? So definitely the question is the number 1 option is correct. So the television is like a rectangular in shape. Okay, so let us go to the question number 32. So choose the shape in the top right. So it is top. Okay, in the top row there are 3 figures and towards our right this figure is there. So it is definitely a circle. So you can read all other options. Okay, so the options are like circle, ice cream cone, flower and none of these. So we are having this circle, and that is why our question number 1 is correct. Okay, so this was like okay, so this was question number 32. Yeah. So now we will check the question number 33, which is asking Mehul saw the following balls at the sporting goods store. So on a actually goods store, we saw all these So he decided to count how many of these balls there were. So he made a table of these balls, which is his table. So after, like, okay, I hope you can see these options, not all the options. Okay. So, like, let me tell you, this type of ball, he is having 3, and the rest are like 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So, like this type of ball, he is having 5. So, question option 1 is not correct. So, question 2, we will see this type is 5, it is correct. And this type of ball is having 3. So, this table is correct. Okay. So, now the question option number 3 is not clearly visible. So, you can now see that this is 3 and this is 5, which is just opposite and which is not correct. Okay. So let us jump on to the option number, that is 34. Which picture shows the basket inside the tent? So you are having like tents and a basket. So this is the tent, this is the basket, this is the tent, this is the basket. So the question is asking to find out which picture shows the basket inside the tent. So in this figure, the basket is inside the tent. So the answer is option 1. So students, you must be seeing that how this question are easy. So definitely I will suggest you to like appear for all the Olympiad, like math, science, English. Okay, so do appear in all these Olympiad exams and your intelligence level will definitely increase. Okay, you will become a smarter and smarter. Okay, so let us read the question number 35, which is asking on which color is the spinner more likely to land. This is options are like white, gray, white and gray. So this is actually green in color, but in options it is telling like gray. So now if your answer will be like white, you have to choose the option 1, and if your answer will be like green, you have to choose gray. So this is a printing mistake, I think. Okay, so if we will spin the spinner, then more likely it is to be landed on the this green area. Okay, so this area is big. Suppose 10 times you spin the wheel, then definitely 8 or 9 times, so the spinner will be pointing or will be landed in this green area. So our answer will be green, but here in place of green it is written as gray. So you have to tick the answer like gray. So let's look at the next question. So which is asking like which object is shaped like a cone. So you are very familiar with the cone because you like have ice creams of this shape every time. So this is the cone. So this is a like a bed or gift or cap. So none of these. So which object is shaped like a cone? So is the bed is like cone, is the cap is like cone, or gift means this is the gift. So we are having this cap in the shape of a cone. Okay, so next the question number 37. How many faces does this shape have? So if you take a duster or any like rectangular packet, so you can count the number of faces being at home. So let me try to make you understand. So this is one face and this is one face. Okay, and this face and the opposite of this is also one face. Okay, so 3, and this face opposite is this one and this is also one. So in this like side to side, you will have 4 faces, and top and bottom another 2 faces. So you can count. So if you have little bit doubt on this question, so take a rectangular object. So it can be a like thick book, it can be your like any box, okay, any carton, okay, it can be like anything. So when you will count, you can see that there are six faces in this type of boxes. So what has been done to this letter? See, in the first figure the letter is here, and in the second figure the little letter has slipped from his original place. So let us look at the options. So it is saying that it is flipped, it is turned, or it is slide. Okay, it has been slided. Okay, so slip, slide, both are having same meaning. Okay, so let us discuss about the question number 39. So how many marbles are there? Estimate. So you don't have to perfectly correct on this. So you can estimate. Okay, so proper counting is not required. So it is the options are about 40, about 70, can't say, or none of this. Can't say. Okay, you can say, because if you will count, then definitely you can say, but I will suggest not to count. So if you will estimate, so let us first check. So let us count some of this this area. Okay, so this is 1 2 3 4 and 5 6 7 8 9 10. Okay, so in this area the number of figure is 10. So you have to estimate. Suppose you just randomly make a compound like this. So you will have near to 11 12, or this much of, so you can take it as 10. So again this area you will have 10. So again this area you will have 10. So again 10 plus 10 20 plus 30 plus 40. So it is more than 40. So you can have 10 in this area, you can have 10 in this area, and you can have 10 in this area. So it is about 70 would be the correct answer. Okay, it is more than 40. So our answer, if we will estimate, then our answer would be 70. Okay, so let us go to the next question, which is the last question of this session and also of this question paper. So the table shows a description of four printers. Okay, so printers are used to print different documents. So printer 1 prints 40 pages per minute. Okay, very good. Printer 2 prints 1 page every 3 seconds. This seems to be a very slower one. Okay, no problem. 1 page every 3 seconds. Okay, very slow. So prints 30 pages per minute. Okay, that means it takes 2 seconds to print a page. So printer 4 prints 3 pages per second. So the unit of time is minute in 2 cases and seconds in 2 cases. So that is the question is asking us which is the slowest. We have to find the slowest printer, that is the efficiency of which printer is very low. Okay, so the printer which will print less pages in 1 minute will be the slowest one. Okay, let us check. So it is printing 40, so it's it can 40 pages in a minute. So we have to find the efficiency of the second printer. It prints 1 piece every 3 seconds. So in each 3 seconds it prints 1 page. So to print the next page, you have to wait for next 3 seconds. Okay, so how many 3 seconds are there in 1 minute? So if we'll see, 1 minute is having 60 seconds, and if we'll group 60 seconds in the group of 3 seconds, so you will get 20. So in each group of 3 seconds you will have 1 page. So definitely you will have 20 pages in a minute. So the third printer is prints 30 pages, so it is little bit faster than the previous one. And the fourth printer is printing 3 pages per second. So if it is printing 3 pages per second, and then this printer is quite fast, so it will print 60 into 3. So 180 pages per minute. So it is the fastest one. It can print 3 pages per second. In 1 second, it will print 3 seconds. So in 1 second it will print 3 pages, in 60 seconds, so 60 times 3, so 60 times 3 is 6, 3 times is 18, and this 0 will come here, so it can print 180 pages. So this is the fastest printer and this is the slowest printer, that is printer 3 is our answer, that is the slowest printer. See, as you can see, so the last questions are little bit difficult, you can say, but if you practice more and more and will come to this channel for more and more question paper solutions, then definitely your intelligence level will increase and you will crack these Olympiads, okay, easily. So that was for this session. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you can get notified as and when I upload a new videos for you. So don't forget to like and share the videos with your friends and other family members so that they can also get benefited from this tutorials. Okay, so if you liked something about this video and if you like to change something in this tutorials, and do comment below. So that's it for today. Thank you. Bye bye.